हेलो बच्चों, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट अवर व्हाट एवर अवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. ओके, सो वी आर कंटिन्यू अवर पॉइंट. ओके, सो एज यू नो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट व्हाट? यस, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ बेसिस. व्हाट बेटा? प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ, यस, प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ बेसिस. ओके, इन प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ बेसिस we discuss when your metal is reacts with water. Okay, now it's time to discuss about, okay, by the action of water on your metallic oxide. Okay, see here, whatever our small b point in that preparation of bases, action of water on what beta? Yes, metallic oxides. So that metallic oxides is what beta here? Metallic oxides, you are either K2O, then Na2O, etc. Okay, so we will discuss with reaction. Okay, so see here, when your Na2O plus H2O, Na2O solid plus H2O liquid, yes, obviously what here you will get? Base. Okay, we are preparing base. Okay, so here NaOH, so 2 NaOH for balancing the reaction. Yes, our reaction also balanced. So whatever this in what? In physical state, aqueous. Okay, suppose if our calcium oxide, your solid plus H2O liquid. So what beta here? Yes, you will get what? CaOH twice aqueous. What beta? CaOH twice. Okay, so see here, whatever our next point, so whatever our next reaction, preparation, okay, so we get here NaOH first, then what we get? Calcium hydroxide in aqueous state. Okay, so we will discuss here our next part. Okay, so that next reaction we will discuss here, double displacement. What beta here? Double displacement. Okay, so see here, in double displacement, what will happen? In double displacement here, okay, so here in double displacement reaction, what you will get? You will get base or not? See, yes, by double displacement. Okay, so for that double displacement, we want here what? Yes, we want here for double displacement AlCl3 plus NaOH. Okay, AlCl3 plus NaOH. So beta, what you will get here? Yes, before only I told, wherever possible we have to do here breaking. Okay, so see here, we will get here breaking Al plus, as your metal is always electropositive, non-metal negative. Yes, here what? Plus and minus, then you can easily write your product. Okay, so what you will get? AlOH thrice, okay, AlOH thrice plus NaCl you will get. So for beta balancing here 3, so here we have to write 3, then here also 3. So we will cross check whether our reaction is balanced or not. 1 Al, 1 Al, 3 Cl, yes, 3 Cl, 3 Na, yes, 3 Na, 3 oxygen, yes, 3 hydrogen. So our reaction is balanced completely. Okay, then whatever our this AlOH thrice, these are formed in the, okay, whatever your AlOH thrice is, what you will get? In the form of precipitate. Okay, in the form of precipitate we will get. So now we will discuss by the action of oxygen on simply metals. Okay, by the action of, say, in preparation of bases, by the action of oxygen on metal. Okay, so as you know beta, here very much easy example here. Okay, so see here, that example, your lithium plus O2, yes, what you will get? Li2O. So here you must know this formula, lithium oxide. So for balancing, yes, here 2 oxygen, so here 2, so beta, this how much now? Li4. Okay, Okay, understood this thing? So simply you will get what? Lithium oxide, Li2O. Now we will discuss whatever action of, okay, by the action of oxygen on metal sulfide, then also we will get what? Basis. Okay, so that also we will discuss here. Okay, so see, by the action of, yes, by the action of oxygen, by the action of oxygen on what? Yes, metal sulfides. Okay, so metal sulfides here. Okay, so whatever your metal sulfides, so as you know, metal sulfide ZnS, we can take here example. Okay, and we will get what? After oxidation, ZnO is what your base. Okay, ZnS plus O2, so what you will get here? It will oxidize, so ZnO plus what? SO2, sulfur dioxide we will get. Okay, so for balancing here, see how Zn here, how much Zn and how much your O2. Okay, so see, for balancing you will take here 2, so here also 2, then how many now? Oxygen 2 and this 2, yes, our reaction balance, 2 Zn 2 Zn, 2 sulfur, no, here 2 sulfur, so beta here what? Yes, 3 oxygen. Now we will cross check our whatever we reaction balance or not. 2 Zn, yes, 2 Zn, 2 sulfur, yes, here also 2 sulfur, 6 oxygen, yes, this 2 and this 4. Okay, 6 oxygen. So it is our, means here ZnO, here zinc oxide you will get as a base. Okay, now we will discuss next. Okay, in the preparation of bases also. Now whatever our next, by the decomposition of salts. Okay, so see here, forbidden here, by the decomposition, by the decomposition of salts. Okay, by the decomposition of salts. So whether beta that salts is your carbonates or either they're in nitrates. Okay, so we will see here first. Okay, when your metallic carbonates and bicarbonates after heating, what you will get? Okay, so we will start that also. Okay, you are habitual of this reaction. Okay, and you will get here what? Basic oxide you will get. Okay, so see what you will get by the decomposition of salt. Suppose if I will take here CuCO3, what beta? CuCO3. So after heating, what you will get? Yes, CuO plus CO2 simply. Okay, these are our, as you know, this reaction. Suppose I will take here magnesium carbonate on heating. Yes, you will get what beta? MgO plus CO2. Our reaction also is balanced. No need to balance separately for this such type of reaction. Yes, CuO and CO2 gas will evolve. Okay, now you will get when you heated metal nitrides, then also you will get what? Basic oxide. So we will say that also examples. Okay, by heating, yes, by heating, say, by heating metal nitrites. So as you must know, what is a nitrites and nitrite? Nitrate ion is what? NO3 minus ion, and nitrite means what? NO2 minus. Okay, so nitrite example, KNO2. Okay, NaNO2. Then your metal nitrate, NaNO3. Okay, in that NaNO3, chill saltpetre. Okay, then KNO3, your what? Indian saltpetre. Okay, so these are what? Simply ores. In that metals and non-metals, we saw this all examples of Chile saltpetre and Indian saltpetre. Okay, so you must know this all. Okay, so here, after when you heat your metal nitrate, so we will take here example zinc nitrate. Okay, it is available in our lab also. Zinc nitrate, when you heat this, okay, you will get important basic oxide. Here you will get what beta? ZnO plus NO2 gaseous. S plus O2 gaseous, here you will get. Okay. So for balancing, yes, one Z and here also N2. So suppose if you write here 2. Okay. So here very much important to balance this reaction. Okay. So oxygen, how much beta? 6. So here also what? Yes, oxygen. Here 1, then 4. Yes, 6 oxygen. 1 Z N, 1 Z N. Okay. Nitrogen 2, nitrogen 3. 6 oxygens are there. So see 1. This 4, 5. No, here 7 they are occurring. Okay. So we want to balance with us another number. Okay. So see, suppose if you take here, if you will take here 2, so what will happen? Yes, here also 2 ZNO. Okay, then 2 nitrogen, 2N. Now what will happen? Yes, 4NO2 beta. Okay, so say we will cross check again 6, 12 total. 6 to 12 total oxygen. So 2 oxygen, yes, 4 to the 8, 10, and it's 2. Yes, our reaction is balanced here. Okay, so these are all what you will get, gaseous product, NO2. Nitro group. Okay, what you will get? Nitrogen dioxide or simply what? NO2 gases. Suppose we will heat another also. Okay, calcium carbonate. Okay, suppose if we will do this reaction with the calcium carbonate. So CaNO3 twice. Okay, solid. Or when you heat the same reaction will occur. What you will get here? Yes, CaO. As a basic oxide you will get plus same product, same byproduct you will get here. Okay, NO2 gaseous plus O2 gaseous. Okay, yes, these are what, both are in solid state. Then for balancing here, take 2, here what, yes, here also 2 and here 4, then our reaction is balanced. So you must know this type of reaction also. So in exam they will ask, what will happen when your zinc nitrate is heated and what will happen when your calcium nitrate will heated? Okay, what is the product and byproduct? At that time, you have to write complete this reaction with a balanced product. With a balanced product and your byproduct. Okay, I hope you understood all these things. Okay, now we will discuss here most important, that is properties of bases. In that we will first discuss physical properties of bases. Okay, say here physical, say yes beta, physical properties of bases. So beta, simple physical property as you know. Okay, so what they are bitter in taste, they are producing what, OH minus ions in aqueous solution. So we call that soluble alkali. Okay, well, soluble bases, what we call that as alkali. Okay, sometimes insoluble bases also we will get. Okay, so here one of the here important thing is, so bases are having a soapy touch. Okay, so with the help of now whatever we are discussing with indicators, so that most important physical property we will discuss. So this property first, as you write, okay, they are bitter in taste, soapy in touch, they are producing OH minus in aqueous solution, so we call it as a what, alkali. Understood? So now whatever our second, that second we are dealing with indicator, dealing with what beta? Indicator. So see here, how we can deal this with indicator. Indicator and changes of color. Okay, changes color in basic medium. Color change in what? In where? Yes, in basic medium. Okay, indicator. So as you know beta, litmus solution. First word beta, litmus solution. Yes, what will be the change? Yes beta, red to blue, red to blue. I will prepare I will prepare one separate video for this all. whatever your indicators, how it will change this color. Okay, that experimentally I will show you. Okay, I will prepare a separate video for that. Litmus solution understood. Now see here, methyl orange. Yes, methyl orange, what will happen? Yes, its color changes from orange to yellow. Orange to yellow, methyl orange color. Basic color is what? That orange. Okay, third, phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, what beta? These are simple. What? How it is simple? Yes, they are changing color from colorless to pink color in basic medium. Okay, as I already told you, in acidic medium what will happen. Okay, then turmeric. Yes, beta, turmeric. Suppose if you take turmeric, then what color changes? Yes, reddish brown in basic medium. Reddish brown color. Okay, then now if you take China rose indicator, what beta here? China rose indicators, then what you will get? Yes, they will get here in basic medium color green. So this thing you must know, they will ask directly in your exam. Okay, so you concentrate on these whatever indicators and color changes in basic medium, very very so much important. Okay, now we will discuss how your bases are good electrolytes. Okay, third hour. Okay, see here, third property. Bases are good. Yes, good what? Electrolytes. How beta? Bases are good electrolytes when they are dissolving in water. Okay, water producing ions. Okay, that means they conduct electricity. They conduct electricity. That's why we are showing this. These are what they are showing, electrolytic property, whatever your basis. Okay, now fourth we will see, whatever our fourth. Okay, so see in that fourth point, your bases are corrosive in nature. Bases are corrosive in nature. Okay, how bases are corrosive in nature? But they are harm, but as compared to acids, whatever intensity is low as compared to acids. They are corrosive, obviously they are corrosive. Okay, but beta, what sometimes they are showing slight burn as compared to, yes, as compared to acids. Okay, now these are all about what your physical properties. Now we will discuss here chemical properties of bases. Okay, so ready with this. Chemical properties. Yes, chemical properties of bases. See here, in chemical properties of bases, here very much important, that is when your metal is reacts with, okay, acid and base, you will get what? Salt plus water. Okay, these are what? Simple chemical properties. So now, after that, reaction with metals we have to discuss mainly. Okay, reaction of bases with metals. Reaction of base with what? With beta, metal. But suppose if you take here Zn plus NaOH. So here, so much important here, concentrate on this. Zinc plus NaOH, you will get here sodium zincate. Okay, that it is in complex form. Okay, like as you know, when you're aluminum plus NaOH, what you will get? Sodium aluminate, NaAlO2. Like that in Zn, NaOH, because these are what? Amphoteric oxides. What beta? Amphoteric oxides. It means what? They will react with both your acids as well as bases. Okay, so see here, what you will get? Na2ZnO2. These are what? Yes, sodium zincate you will get here. Sodium zincate along with H2 gas. Along with H2 gas. Okay. You keep in mind, very, very much important this reaction. Don't confuse. If you other people, they will do like this. Yes, ZnO is twice you will get. But no. Here you will get what? Sodium zincate. So these two reactions you keep in mind. When your aluminum reacts with NaOH, you will get sodium aluminate, NaLO2. And when your zinc is reacts with NaOH, you will get what? Sodium zincate. Okay. Don't confuse in that. Very, very much important this reaction. Frequently asked question in exam. Okay. So, now it's time to what? Balance the reaction. Okay. So, here 2. 1 ZN, 1 ZN2, Na2, Na2, oxygen. Yes, 2 oxygen, 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen. Now, so our reaction is what? Completely correct. Okay. Now, when you will get, so suppose some student they are thinking about, so sir, when you will get our zinc hydroxide? So see here, that also answer we have. See, Zn, what beta? ZnSO4 plus NaOH. Okay, ZnSO4 plus NaOH, so beta. Both are in form, yes, in aqueous solution. What you will get? Then here you will get what? Zinc hydroxide. Okay, ZnOH twice. You can break metal, non-metal, metal positive, non-metal, whatever SO4. Okay, is what? Your anion part, plus part is minus part. Plus part, minus part. Okay. So what you will get? Zinc hydroxide you will get along with what? Yes, along with, obviously you will get a stable binary compound. That is what? Na2SO4 aqueous. And here what you will get? Precipitate. Here what you will get? Precipitate. Understood? So you have to balance this reaction, beta. Yes, 2. 1 ZN, 1 ZN, 2 NA, 2 NA. Okay, 2 oxygen, 2 hydrogen. Yes, our reaction also balance. Correctly, we balance our reaction. Okay, now see here, whatever our next. Action of non-metallic oxides on your basis. Okay, so ready with this also, beta. Okay. Small b we can write here, reaction of non-metallic oxide on where? On basis. Then what you will get? We will see immediately, beta. Okay, then suppose if you are taking strong alkali, so beta, whatever your strong alkali, they will absorb CO2 from atmosphere and they will convert into what? Sodium carbonate along with water. Okay. So see here that reaction. NaOH is your alkali. Sodium hydroxide plus CO2. They are absorbing CO2 from atmosphere. Then you will get what? Na2CO3 plus H2. Okay. So you have to balance this reaction with 2. So our reaction also balanced. Okay. Now one thing, reaction will occur in the presence of, okay, like that your NaOH are absorbing CO2. Okay, like your, suppose MgOH twice, your magnesium hydroxide also, they will absorb SO2 from air. Okay, so see here their reaction. MgOH twice plus what? SO2. Okay, so they are absorbing SO2 from atmosphere. So what you will get? Magnesium sulfide, MgSO3 plus H2 you will get. So for balancing, what we have to do? So say 1 Mg, 1 Mg, 1S, 1S, O3, 4 oxygen. Yes, here 2, 4, and hydrogen also 2. No need to balance this reaction, beta. Okay. our reaction is balanced. Okay, so and our last reaction in this, okay, when your alkaline, whatever soluble base, it will react with NaOH. Okay, soluble base, when it reacts with, or we can say alkaline base reacts with your NaOH. So what will happen, beta? So see, that also in last, whatever your chemical properties of bases, means reaction of your base with alkaline soluble base. So that alkaline soluble base is what? Okay, see here, NH4Cl, this alkaline salt, plus, okay, plus what, beta? Your NaOH. If you done this reaction, so what you will get? Yes, you will get NaCl as a product. Yes, NaCl as a product, plus H2O plus ammonia gas. Okay, ammonia gas you will get. So you have to balance this reaction, 1N1NH4 5U, so 3 3 2 5U, then 1Na 1Na oxygen. Yes, one oxygen only. So our reaction also here balance. So you must know these all reactions. So very, very much important here, these all reactions. Okay, so we discuss here physical properties of bases, chemical properties of bases. If still if you have any doubts, you can send on WhatsApp at any time. Okay, so take care, stay safe and stay home. Thank you very much.